It's get started, so it's pitched right at the very beginner level. What we'll do, we'll go through exercises, we'll learn the exercises one at a time, and then we'll bring it all in as a circuit. A circuit is a approach. What we'll do an exercise followed by a little bit of rest, followed by an exercise, and go in a circuit way. After that, we might change it up a little bit, change up the exercises. All you need to know, everything will be explained to you nice and simple. You'll be able to follow it. You have enough time to do the exercise over and over again to really get it into your head. And by the end of it, hopefully, you should be pros at it. Okay, we'll wait another minute before we start our warm-up. Like I said, please grab a drink if you haven't got one. Okay, so let's start the warm-up. We're going to start it on the floor. We're going to start in a press-up position. We're then going to drop down onto our toes. Okay, this is going to be our starting position for the first bit of the warm-up. First move we're going to do is a dynamic stretch. You're going to reach your hand through the other side and alternate. I'm going to take a second to really feel that stretch. One more on either side. Good. Next one is we're going to come onto your toes, and it's going to be a big lunge. So bring that knee up to your elbow, back down the other side, lunge up. And again, alternate either side, left and right. Okay, two more. Good, okay, we're going to stand up. So that's the first bit of the warm-up done. We've done our stretches, now we've got to get the pulse going, our blood flowing. So we can start with some high knees. So how high you bring your knees is up to you. The higher your knees, the harder it's going to be. What I like to do, put my hands out in front of me, a target for my knees. Okay, now the opposite, heel flicks. So what that looks like from the side, you're going to flick your heels up towards your bum. Now, if you just want to run on the spot, that's absolutely fine. You just get the blood pumping. Okay, next one. We're going to slow it down a bit. Do some arm circles. So bring them forward nice and big. We're going to bring them from big to small, make them smaller and smaller. And then gradually bring them bigger again. Did you feel that one in your shoulders? Okay, same again. We're going to go backwards now. So start nice and big. And then gradually make them smaller and smaller. And then bigger again. Okay, last one is going to be some star jumps, okay? So this warm-up is going to be dynamic movements, pulse raiser, get you nice and warm before we start the class. Okay, I'm now going to chuck the music on. If it's too loud, let me know. Likewise, if it's too quiet, let me know in the chat. Okay, so the way this is going to work, I'm going to show you an exercise. I'm going to show you how it's done, what it does, what muscles it uses. Then you're going to do that exercise for 30 seconds. I'm going to show you another exercise, you're going to rest, and then you get to 30 seconds. We'll go for that for about four exercises. So the first one is on the floor. So back on the floor, head on the floor, and you're going to bring your feet up close to your bum, and the exercise is a glute bridge, a single leg bridge. So you change that music nice and quick. Okay, hope that's a little bit better. So single leg glute bridge. So we're going to bring that left leg out. My left and right knees are still together. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to push my hips towards the ceiling. I come down, bum touching the floor, go back up. I'm going to do three on my left leg, three on my right leg. So my knees are still together, thumb touches ball, and it comes up. So I'll let you guys 30 seconds, single leg glute bridge. The regression of this to make it slightly easier is to keep both feet on the floor and then just to press your hips towards the ceiling. So that's going to make it easier. If you want to make it harder, one leg at a time. Remember to swap legs after three. You make it easier. Both feet on the floor. Good, we've got another three, two, one. Okay, now you guys get to rest. Next exercise is a dorsal raise. So use this 30 seconds as rest as I show you the exercise. You're staying on the floor. This time you're going on your chest. Hands on the side of your head, feet together. And all you're gonna do is bring your legs up and your head up at the same time. To make this easier, hands out to the side, legs apart, same thing. Head up, legs up. So that is your exercise. 30 seconds for you guys to have a go now. So the harder version. Fingers on the side of your head, toes together, both coming up at the same time. You make that easier. Hands out to the side, legs apart, same thing. Keep going, guys. You've got another 10 seconds. This is a back exercise. You might not have done it before, but it's very good for your back. Okay, and rest, 30 seconds rest. So the next one is a mountain climber. So you get your 30 second rest as I show you the exercise. You're gonna start in a press up position. You're then gonna drive your right knee into your chest, followed by your left, and alternate nice and quick. So this is a mountain climber, and it's an ab exercise. If you wanna make it slightly easier, all you need is a chair or the edge of the sofa or the edge of the bed. Put your hands on the surface and then do it from there. It's gonna make it easier for you. The higher the incline, the easier it's gonna be. Okay guys, so I'll let you go for 30 seconds. Mountain climbers. So nice and light on your toes. Bring your knee into your chest. On the floor, it's going to be the harder version. If you want that easier version, use an incline. Same thing, exactly the same thing. So nice and light in your toes. You've got three, two, one. Good. 30 second rest for you guys as I show you the new exercise. Last one, exercise number four. And it's as simple as getting on the ground and getting back up. I'm gonna call them get-ups. So you're gonna go down, lie on your back, and then get back up again. It looks easy, but it's hard, okay? You can get up by any means possible to make it easier. You can use a chair or the edge of the bed, and all you can do is sit down and get back up again. Try it on the floor to start off with, and if you need to, no, go onto the chair or your step edge of the sofa, something like that. Okay, 30 seconds of get-ups in 3, 2, 1, go. So completely flat on the ground, and up you get, and then back down. Up you get. What you can do as well is you come up, put those hands in the air, back down again. You've got another 10 seconds. Keep going, guys. Can use that box, that chair to help. If you do it on the floor, it's going straight down and straight back up. It's a funny one. It definitely gets your blood going. And 3, 2, 1, perfect. And rest. Okay, so we're gonna take about a minute's rest. The next thing we're gonna do is put all of those exercises in a circuit. So we'll start off with the glute bridge. We're on the floor. We'll do that for 30 seconds. Then we'll have a little 15 second rest. And then we'll go into the dorsal raises. The ones on the floor again, those ones. 15 second rest. Mountain climbers, 15 second rest, get ups. Done, okay? So you're doing the exercise you've done already. The same amount of time, which is 30 seconds. This time you've got less rest in between. You've only got that 15 second rest as opposed to the 30 second rest. Okay, and we're gonna start in 3, 2, 1, go. So we're gonna start with those glute bridges on the floor. Remember, the single legs gonna make it harder. And then feet together, it's gonna make it easier. Remember, if you're doing single leg, you're three on one side. You change foot, three on the other side. You've got 3, 2, 1, good. 15 seconds rest. So the next exercise is the dorsal raise, and we're gonna go in 5 seconds. It's 15 second rest, will go nice and quick. So get ready, 3, 2, 1. So it's a dorsal raise. To make it easier, hands out to the side, legs spread apart. You're still bringing yourself up. What's the time? We've got 10 seconds to go. If anyone's still got their hands on the side of the head, very well done. This is the tough exercise. And that's us done. Good. Little rest. 15 second rest. The next one is our mountain climbers. So remember this one, you can use your chair or you can do it on the floor. Okay. And we're going to go again in 3, 2, 1 into the 30 seconds. Good, that's 15 seconds in. We got 15 to go. We've got 5 seconds to go. Good, and rest, little 15 second rest. Last exercise is the get ups. Again, do them on the floor, it's gonna make it hard. On the edge of a chair, it's gonna make it easier. Okay, and in 3, 2, 1, last one, 30 seconds is the get ups. So it doesn't matter how you get up, as long as you do. It's your life, 10 seconds to go, keep going guys. 5 to go, and 3, 2, 1, perfect, and rest. You can take another minute rest. The next thing we're gonna do is another circuit. We're gonna make it harder. The way to make a circuit harder is either by increasing the amount of exercises we're gonna do, increasing the rest, or increasing the amount of time we do the exercises for. What we're gonna do is decrease the rest. And when I say decrease the rest, we're gonna take it out completely. So we did 30 seconds and a little 15 second rest. Now we're gonna do 30 seconds straight into the other exercise. So no rest. You go from the glute bridge straight into those dorsal raises, okay? No rest, it's gonna be 2 minutes of work before we get our next minute rest, okay? And we're gonna start in 3, 2, 1. So we'll start with the glute bridges. Remember, you're gonna make it harder, one leg out. By now, you're gonna know what level suits you best. Remember, you can always start on the harder one and then drop down to the easier one as the exercise progresses. And 3, 2, 1, good. Okay, straight into the dorsal raises, 30 seconds. Like I said, really good exercise for your back. to make this one a little bit easier, you can also take a little rest between each rep. So you do a rep, have a little rest, and then go again. You've got 5 seconds to go. Good, straight into the mountain climbers. Your two exercises in. You've got two to go, we've got a minute to go. Nice and quick with those feet. Last 10. And 3, 2, 1. Last one is the get ups. I'm going to do this one as the regression, which is going to be onto the chair. 30 seconds. 20 seconds now, and you get a big long rest. You've got 5 seconds to go. Good, and rest. Okay. We're going to take another minute rest. Please grab a drink if you need one. Okay, we're going to do one final circuit with these exercises here. We're going to make it harder again. This time, we're going to increase the amount of time we're doing our exercises for. So instead of doing 30 seconds, we're now going to do 55 seconds. But just to be kind, you're going to get that 15 second rest back in between the exercises. So the circuit we just did was 2 minutes. This one's going to be 4 minutes. You have those little rests in between your exercises. Same 4 exercises. After we've done this one, we'll change up, do something different. Okay, we're going to start in 3, 2, 1. Go. So the first one is glute bridges. Forty-five seconds. Those extra 15 seconds will really make a difference. Remember, single leg. You have to alternate between each leg after each couple of reps. If you have your feet together on the floor, you don't have to worry about alternating. We've done 35 seconds, so we've got 10 to go. And 3, 2, 1. Good, little rest, 15 second rest. Next exercise, we're staying on the floor, but it is the dorsal raise, so we're going to do that. Your chest flat on the floor. Okay, that 15 seconds goes quick. Get into our dorsal raises now. So think about bringing that head up and your feet up at the same time. Making it easier, hands out, legs out, same thing. And I hope my mic isn't annoying when it's hitting the mat. I'm hoping you can't hear that. We'll be on. We're on 30 seconds, we've got another 15 to go. Remember, little rest between each rep is going to make it a little bit easier for you. Take a couple of seconds before going again. We'll be on. We're on 40 seconds. And 3, 2, 1. Good. Sit yourself up. Okay, we've got 2 exercises to go. The mountain climbers and the get-ups. We're going to start in 3, 2, 1. 45 seconds worth of mountain climbers. I'm going to do this one on the chair. With the mountain climbers, the quicker you go, the harder it's going to be for you. If you want to take it up a notch, try and get those feet moving faster. Last 15 seconds. Last 5, four, three, two, one. Good, and rest. We've got our last 15 second rest. And then we've got our last exercise, which is the get-ups. And 15 seconds is up in three, two, one. Last 45 seconds is the get-ups on the floor, flat down, up as quick as you can, hands in the air, and back down. Fiona on the screen, absolutely brilliant. He's still doing them on the floor. That really does make a difference. You would imagine your legs are probably burning by now. Keep going. We've got 5 seconds left. And three, two, one. Good, and rest. Okay, we'll take a nice minute break. So please grab a drink. Now we're going to change it up slightly. So the circuit we just did was a full body circuit. So we had legs in there, we had abs in there, we had our upper body in there, and we also had like a pulse raiser in there, which was the get ups at the end. Now we're going to kind of condense all of that into one, and we're going to do a leg circuit, okay? So it's going to be 3 leg exercises. One of them is going to be the glute bridge we've done already, so you don't see that again. The other two are going to be squats and lunges. So just like the start, we're going to learn the exercise for 30 seconds, and then we're going to get into the circuit. First one is a squat. So put your feet shoulder width apart, toes slightly pointing out, and all you're going to do is squat down and back up. Your hands can go by your sides. Go out in front, they can go across, it's up to you. So what that looks like from the side is down and up. What's really important is I keep my back nice and straight, trying to keep my chest looking out, okay? In terms of how low you go, it will depend on how strong and flexible you are. As long as your back's straight, I don't mind if you squat down this low, or this low. As long as your back doesn't start arching over, it's fine by me. We'll do another 10 seconds of squats. Good, and three, two, one. Well done. Take a little rest. The next one's going to be lunges. Lunges, another leg exercise. It's going to be a big step forward and then back, and you alternate your legs. What that looks like from the side is 2 right angles. So you can see my legs. I've got 2 right angles. My knee is just above the floor. It doesn't whack into the floor, but it doesn't stop up here. And then I always alternate my legs. Again, hands can either go out to the side because there's a little bit of balance with this one. On your hips, it's up to you. Let's do 20 seconds of lunges just to really learn the exercise. What's going to make it easier for you is a reverse lunge. So if you're having trouble going forwards, all you can do is step backwards. My legs have still got those right angle shapes, but stepping backwards tends to be a little bit nicer for balance. So if you're struggling going forwards, just do a reverse lunge, which is backwards. Okay, so there are 2 new exercises. We're now going to put them into the circuit. So we've got the glute bridge, the squats, and the lunges. We're going to start 30 seconds with a little 15 second rest in between. Only 3 exercises, so it's less exercises, but because it's all on the legs, it's going to be tough. In 3, 2, 1, let's go. So the glute bridge, we did these earlier. Single leg makes it harder, legs together make it easier. I'm well off my mat, there we go. You're going to go 1 leg at a time, alternate them. You've got 5 seconds to go. Good, and rest. Little 15 second rest. Next exercise is the squats, okay? Because this is legs, your legs might get a little bit tired. So when we are resting, shake them out, keep walking, don't sit down. It'll make it worse if you sit down and get back up afterwards. Next one is the squats. So 30 seconds, let's go. Straight into them. So it doesn't matter how far you go down, as long as your back's nice and straight, your chest and head looking out. Good, we got another 5 seconds to go. Perfect, and a little rest. Our 15 second rest. We've got our last exercise, which is the lunges. Okay, and we're gonna start in 3, 2, 1. Let's go, so a big step forwards and back. 30 seconds of lunges, then we rest. Halfway through, another 15 seconds. You can use that reverse lunge, it's gonna make it a little bit easier for balance. You're still gonna be working your legs, you're still gonna be working your quads. Last 3, 2, 1, perfect, okay. We're gonna take a little rest, and then we're gonna do one more final circuit. This time, just like the first set of circuits, we're gonna take the rest out. So we're gonna go 30 seconds for the glute bridge, 30 seconds for the squats, 30 seconds for the lunges, no rest, okay? So it's only 90 seconds, but because it's all on your legs, they get no rest, it is quite tough. We're gonna go in 3, 2, 1. Go, so this is your last 90 seconds of the class. So if you can, try and do all the harder versions. This is your last little bit of work before we do our cool down. Another 5 seconds for our glute bridge. Perfect, okay, straight into those squats. So no rest. 30 seconds of squats have started. If you want to make these even harder than they are, just increase the speed, so do more squats. It's going to make it a little bit easier. Slow it down. Take a rest between each one. Shake your legs up if you need to. Okay, we got another 3, 2, 1. Last one is the lunges. So 30 seconds of lunges. No rest. It's 3 leg exercises back to back. You're feeding your legs, that's good, that means they're working hard. Another 10 seconds. Good, and 3, 2, 1. Perfect, and rest. Okay. So, let me turn this music off, do a couple of stretches. Actually, I'll turn it down. Oops. Okay, so just to finish up, we'll do a couple of stretches. We'll start with our legs and we'll work our way up. First one, grab the back of your leg, pull it towards your bum. You might need to hold on to something. Good, and change leg. Okay, next one for the backs of your legs. Big wide step out. Then you're gonna reach down and touch your right foot if you can, while keeping your legs nice and straight. If you can't touch your toe like I can, just hold up your leg and go as low as you can. And on the other side. Now into the middle. Again, touch the floor if you can. If you can't, that doesn't matter. You feel a nice stretch in the backs of your legs. Okay, next one. Stay standing up. It's a nice big side bend over to the side. Okay, guys, I hope you enjoyed the class. So this is Get Started. Obviously, it's pitched at the very beginner level. So you found it was a little bit too easy. Please check out the other classes we do on our box. So on Mondays, we do a box fit at 12:30. Tuesdays, we've got another Get Started at 8:30 in the morning, if that suits you better. We've also got a, what is it, stretch and flex. Nope, we've got a legs, bums and tums on a Tuesday, so at 12:30. Stretch and flex on Wednesday, 12:30. And then we've got two slightly different ones on a Thursday and Friday, which is body and mind at 10:30 and hit and abs at 10:30. Also, please leave a message in the chat. Any feedback's good feedback. It'd be really appreciated. Apart from that, guys, hope you enjoyed it. Hope to see you next week.